and the other end of the beach is steeper, narrower,
right,
and coarser grained. And the ridges are coarser grained.
Okay. And are the ridges higher at that end?
No,
that's the same. About the same. So it doesn't really matter what they're made of then?
No.
Okay. So we just walked off the beach.
Yeah.
Off the back shore onto the beach, and stepped over this little clifflet, which is probably due to erosion from this high astronomical tide. When was that? Earlier this year.
Yes.
And there's a strand line in front of it.
Yes.
And there's this little ridge of pumice just on top of that cliff.
Yes.
So it's all these different things coming together to what will actually form a beach ridge.
Yes, eventually. That's right.
Right.
Yeah.
Now the organic matter, did you ever see that preserved?
We don't see it preserved.
Because there's quite a lot of driftwood there.
Yeah. I mean, this thing behind us would be a ridge that would be forming.
Yeah.
You'd get sedimentary units deposited onto that, so they'd be vegetated whilst they're forming.
Right, yeah. And roots in them.
Yeah. But that's where when a big event comes through, that's where the deposit would go. Just smear all
right.
of that through there.
Into the vegetation.
Yeah.
Yeah. So would the vegetation have this sort of trapping effect as well?
Yeah, quite possibly.
Yeah, slowing down the velocity of the water.
Sure. But it's not, I mean, we also see it going over onto roads as well too.
Right, so it goes right through it.
Yeah. Or if there's a road immediately behind the beach, as in some locations, that same sand unit will be deposited across the road.
Right.
So it's not just the vegetation that's causing it to slow down and be deposited
okay.
there. It would always be deposited there.
Right, okay. So what sort of, I mean, the weathering that you have in these parts of the tropics, that would be probably effective enough to remove any organic material
yes.
from the sediment
yes.
through oxidization and,
yes.
and breakdown.
Yes. Very effective.
Yeah. Mm. And I guess the sort of calcareous fossils that you might expect to find, like shells and foraminifera that might be in the beach sand, they'd probably be leached out through acidic groundwater over
that's
time.
That's right. Yeah.
So have you ever found any shells in the older beach ridges?
Not where there's... but generally, no.
Right.
Only if there's an abundance of shells on the beach,
right.
which you tend to find some on the ridges.
Okay.
But generally, no. We don't. We might find the odd one,
mm-hmm.
but it is the odd one.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. And are they etched? Do they look like they've been corroded at all?
Well, we'd only find them in the youngest ridges.
Oh, right, okay.
Not in the oldest ridges.
Right, they've been gone by then.
Yeah. If they're there at all.
Yeah.
They may hate the shells beyond 3,000 years because they've just changed their chemistry so much through weathering.
Oh, right. Mm. Okay, what, just completely replaced by different minerals?
Well, I mean, there's funny things go on between the C13 and C12.
Oh, right.
And it makes the dates unreliable.
Okay.
So, we never... There, where we've got very distinct marine shell beds in the ridges, we never go back beyond 3,000 years because we deem that the dates would be unreliable.
Right. So how did you come to that conclusion?
A guy who actually did his PhD on this in the early 1980s found that conclusion.
In the Gulf of Carpentaria. Oh, yeah. Right. Okay.
And he was doing his own radiocarbon analysis.
Right.
So... and also, you can just see how degraded the shells are by that stage, too.
Yeah.
They really are breaking down.
Yes.
It's just a shell ash.
Yes. Yeah. And then you've got the marine reservoir correction factor, which is a complete mystery to me.
Yeah. That's right.
Yeah.